Hello everyone, today we are going with the chapter The Withering Stone in Irsama, written by Harsh Mandeer. On 27 October 1999, Prashant was visiting his friend in Irsama, a small town in coastal Orissa. In the evening, a dangerous storm blew into town. Prashant had never seen such a storm in his life. Furious wind and continuous rain raged around the house. Prashant, they could hear the trees crashing to the ground and screams of people as the storm blew away their houses. The friend's house made of bricks and mortar. It was strong enough to stand against the wind, but it could not prevent the family's terror as trees fell on the house, cracking the roof and walls. For 36 hours, the storm raged around the house. Water entered their house. The household took to the roof to escape the water flooding inside the house. After 46 hours later, it was the first time Prashant saw the devastation left in the wake of the cyclone. Brown water covered everything. There were dead bodies of animals and people floating in the water. Trees were scattered among the bodies. Not a single house was left standing. The next 2 days, the family and Prashant lived on the roof. Prashant thought the time, Prashant throughout the time worried about his family back home. He wondered if he would lose his family. 3 days later, on the third day, he decided to trek back to his family. The town was still flooded and his friend's family warned him that it would be dangerous. But Prashant was determined, and it was long and difficult journey for Prashant. He used to stick to find his path. As he walked further, he had a first-hand experience of the devastation that he had earlier seen on the roof. He was disturbed by the bodies. He had to push aside as he made his way through the water. These sights also made him feel helpless. He was sure his family has met the same fate as the bodies in the water. When he reached his village, Kalikuda, Prashant was terrified to find his house destroyed. There was no one in the site. He decided to go to nearby Red Cross shelter to search for them. As he entered the shelter, he saw his maternal grandmother. His grandmother rushed to him crying. She thought it was a miracle that he was alive. Prashant took count of his family. He felt grateful to the God that they were all alive. The next day, Prashant took stock to the situation in his village. Lives and homes had been lost. There was very little food left. His community was succumbing to grief and sadness. Though Prashant was only 19, he took charge of the village. He organized a youth group to get rice from the local merchant and distribute it to the survivors. Next, he organized volunteers to clean the shelters and tend to injuries. 5 days later, on the fifth day, a helicopter dropped a few parcels. When it did not return, the youth volunteer collected empty utensils and they had young boys lie on the ground with empty utensils on their bellies. This message go through to the helicopters and relief came frequently thereafter. They were also made children often by the cyclone. Prashant brought them together under one shelter. Women were brought to look after them while men procured for the food. Prashant also realized that the women and children left grieving after losing their families needed to be engaged. So he convinced the women to join the Food for Work NGO program. And for the little children, he organized the cricket matches to distract them. Prashant and the youth task force rejected the government plan for removing the women and children to the institutions. He believed in resetting them in their own community to enable a smoother healing. Prashant, suffering from his experience of the cyclone, found new purpose and comfort in rebuilding his own community. Whenever a woman or children felt sad, they would seek the support of Prashant. His efforts show how a crisis can bring about heroism even in ordinary people.